very important and basic idea of Judaism, Torah, what we see in this table. So we see in this table here the expression which is brought a lot, Yemot HaMashiach, the days of the Messiah, the days of the Mashiach. Now, very often mentioned in different sources, Talmud, Medrash, Kabbalah, those are the expression of this time of Mashiach. Now, amazingly, it appears in very nice verses, which really fits Mashiach. Is it in there? Evi et ha'am hazeh el ha'aretz asher nishba aleihem. God brought the people to this land which he swore to give them. Then we have Moraim Gdolim, great miracles will happen, great things to Israel. And again you have the verse which says that God will change curses, Yafoch Hashem Alecha et ha'klala livracha. God will change the curses which came upon you to blessings. And again, the condition, Ve'et Shvutcha, and God will accept, receive your repentance, and Veshamata Bekol Hashem Elokecha, and you will listen to the voice of God, Vasita Kol Mitzvotah, you do all His commandments. So, beautiful verses, which really fits Mashiach time, coming to the land, settling there, blessings, no more curses, and definitely all depends on the condition of doing tshuva, to listen to the verse of God, which is written here. And what is amazing, perhaps most amazing, is that you have here the date, Mitav Shin Aleph, from 701, between 5701, which is about 1941, and this is exactly the date which the Holocaust started. So how can we understand such a thing? Not only this, that in fact the pupil of the Baal Shem Tov in his book Toldot Yaakov Yosef says about this date, Tavshin Aleph, that this is indicated to be a time of redemption of Messiah in the portion of the Torah, Ki Tisa et Rosh, Bnei Israel, will lift up the head of Bnei Israel. So how it happened to be what exactly written back to it? Shoah. It happened to be Shoah, Holocaust. And not only this, if you go into the last verse here, when you see, you look into it properly, into this verse, very frightening verse, which says in Hebrew, which means in English that fire flames in my wrath and shall have unto the lowest hell and shall consume the earth with her increase. So, frightening, this is exactly the expression of the Holocaust, as you can see, coming here. Now, the verse before tells us why such terrible wrath flamed God. So the verse before, yeah, I did not put all of it, but you can see it in Deuteronomy 32:51, which says, what made God so cross? So it's written the following. The verse, you can see this letter coming there, and it says, they have moved me to jealousy with that which is not God, that have provoked me to anger with their vanities, and I will move them to jealousy with those who are not a people. So, unfortunately, this is what happened. Yeah. And it carries on and says, I will move them to anger with a debased nation. Exactly what the Nazis, the Germans were. Amazingly, seeing that this was a time if Jews will do tshuva, like the verse says here, that tishma bekol Hashem Elokecha, you will listen to the voice of God, you will keep all His commandments, then God will really bring you back to the land, as is written here. And all these wonderful blessings coming to Israel, which comes here. But unfortunately, because Jews did not, we have the Haskalah in Libun, enlightenment, unfortunately many people left the Torah, many people unfortunately took up on some wrong ideas, communism, a lot of the things, socialism, and neglecting Torah, and this is what made God wrath, flamed, and brought this what is written, the hell, the depths of the hell, coming fire, everything which will happen in the Holocaust. So amazingly, seeing really Shoah with this potential, if Jews will, Chas v'Shalom, will not, as they did not listen to rabbis, did not keep Torah properly, look to enlightenment, what they called, this is what brought to the terrible Holocaust. And the best meeting of the year of the Holocaust, which is Tavshin Ayin Aleph, we said, from this year to 1941-40. And this was really days which were suitable to Mashiach, but unfortunately, because of not listening to the Torah, to rabbis, keeping Torah, this terrible tragedy came. So definitely it's an important lesson for the time that we are now. Also, a lot of dangers, even danger of Holocaust, Chas v'Shalom from Iran, atom. So only keeping Torah and mitzvot will save us from all this problem.